Hi everyone, it's me again, Sharon Oyola, and today we're making the Springtime Bunny. And this is actually a modified version of my Valentine's Day teddy bear that's been up here since February 3rd or 4th. And that Valentine's Day bear had heart-shaped feet, so this one has regular feet, as you can see, and I've added the bunny ears. So what I've done is I've put all the modifications into one pattern, so this is one pattern all on its own now, and you can pick up the written pattern on my blog. Hit the link in the description box below this video and it'll bring you right to the written pattern where you'll find the supplies list, the hook size, and the yarn weight and all that good stuff. Okay, and this video will walk you through all the steps of making this bunny and how to sew it together. And also, I designed a little dress to go with the bunny, and it's a springtime dress, and it's made all with single crochet, so there's nothing fancy about this dress at all. It just looks really cute. I'm actually working on the video for this dress right now. The written pattern is already on my blog, and you can hit that link in the description box below this video. It'll bring you right to the written pattern for the dress and the shoes. And the shoes are removable. And it got a little bow in the back. It's really cute. And also available in a different post is the carrot purse and the little basket with carrots in it. And these will also be a video as well. I'm working through all of them. But all the written patterns are available. So today's video will walk you through all the steps of making the bunny and how to sew the bunny together. So if you do make yourself a little bunny, please post pictures on my Facebook page, Emma Grimmy Freely. I'd love to see you. Thanks so much for watching and have fun! So we start by making the head and the body. The head and the body are all one piece. We start at the top of the head and we work our way down to the bottom of the body. Row one, we're going to make a loop with 6 stitches in it. Now I have 2 tutorials here on YouTube that will help you make a loop with 6 stitches. One is called the magic ring, and that one's right here. And the other one's called the chain 2 adjustable loop method, and that one's right here. Once you have your loop with 6 stitches, then you come on back. In row two, we're going to put 2 single crochets in each one of those 6 stitches. And I'll just turn this to the side so you can see what it looks like. This is the last stitch of the row right there underneath this big loop. That's the last one. And the first one is in front here, and you can see the V. There's 2 loops in that V. That's the first stitch. There's the second one, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth, right underneath that big loop. And now we can put a marker into that last stitch we just put in, and that's underneath that big loop. So we just push right through and pull the yarn strand through there, and we're just going to leave it hanging just like that. And we're going to move this marker at the end of every row. Now we can also crochet this starting yarn tail into the second row and just crochet around it, or we can just leave it hanging like I'm going to do. I'm going to leave it hanging, and we're going to tuck it into the head as we work along. So row two is 2 single crochets in each one of those 6 stitches. So now I'm starting row two. I'm going to go into that first stitch, making sure I have 2 loops of that stitch on my hook. Yarn over and pull through. Yarn over and pull through. Now going back into that same stitch hole we were just in, we're going to put another single crochet. Yarn over and pull through. You have 2 loops. Yarn over and pull through those 2 loops. And there was 2 single crochets into the first stitch. Now I'm going to go into the second one and do the same thing. Put 2 single crochets, making sure I have 2 loops of that stitch on my hook. Yarn over, pull through. Yarn over and pull through. Going back in the same stitch hole I was just in and put another single crochet. And that was 2 single crochets into the second stitch. Now I'm going to go into the third one and do the same thing. 1 single crochet, back in the same stitch hole I was just in, and put another single crochet. And that was 2 single crochets into the third stitch. And I'm going to go into the fourth one. 1, going back in the same stitch hole, and 2. And that was 2 single crochets into the fourth. Now I'm going to go into the fifth one. 1, and back in the same stitch hole, and 2. And that was 2 single crochets into the fifth stitch. Now I'm going to go into the sixth one, and you can see it's going to land on that marker, so I'm going to pull the marker out and put in my 2 single crochets.
and that ends row two, and now we have 12 stitches around. I'm going to move my marker, going into that last stitch I just put in, and pull my marker through. Row three, we're going to put one single crochet into the first stitch, two single crochets into the second, and then we're going to repeat that sequence. One into the next, and two into the next, and keep repeating all the way around till you land on the marker. When we land on the marker, we'll be putting in two single crochets. So one single crochet into the first stitch, and then two single crochets into the second. One, and going back in the same stitch hole for two. Now we're repeating that, one single crochet into the next, and two single crochets into the stitch after that. One, and going back in the same stitch hole, and put two. Now we're repeating, one single crochet into the next, and then two single crochets into the stitch after that. Now repeating, one single crochet into the next, and two single crochets into the stitch after that. One single crochet into the next, and two single crochets into the stitch after that. That was one, and going back to the same stitch hole, and put two. And now repeating, one single crochet, and you can see the two single crochets going to land on that marker, so I'll pull the marker out and put in my two single crochets. And that's the end of row three, and now we have 18 stitches around. I'm going to move that marker. Moving on to row four, we're going to put one single crochet into the first, one single crochet into the second, and then two single crochets into the third stitch. And then we're going to repeat that sequence, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, all the way around till we land on the marker. When we land on the marker, we'll be putting in two single crochets. So I'll do the first couple sets with you. One single crochet into the first, one single crochet into the second stitch, and then two single crochets into the third. We're back in the same stitch hole and put another single crochet. And now we're going to repeat that. One single crochet into the next stitch, one single crochet into the stitch after that, and then two single crochets into the one after that. There was one, going back in the same stitch hole and putting two. Now we're just going to keep repeating that sequence. One, one, two, one, one, two, all the way around. And when you land on the marker, you'll be putting in two single crochets. So I'll continue on the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. I'll finish row four. Now we have 24 stitches around. Row five is one single crochet into the next three stitches, and then two single crochets into the fourth. And repeating that sequence all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you'll be putting in two single crochets. So I'll do the first two sets with you. One single crochet in the first, one single crochet into the second stitch, one single crochet into the third, and then two single crochets into the fourth. And now we're going to repeat that sequence. One single crochet in the next stitch, one single crochet into the stitch after that, one single crochet into the next, and then two single crochets into the stitch after that. And now you're going to keep repeating that sequence. One, 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 two. One, 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 two. Keep repeating. When you land on the marker, you'll be putting in two single crochets. So I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we finish off this row. I'll finish row five, and now we have 30 stitches around. Row six is one single crochet in the next four stitches, and then two single crochets into the fifth. Keep repeating that sequence all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you'll be putting in two single crochets. So I'll do the first set with you. One single crochet in the first, one single crochet into the second, one into the third, one single crochet into the fourth, and now two single crochets into the fifth stitch. Now you're going to keep repeating that sequence, one in the next four stitches, and then two single crochets into the fifth. Keep repeating that sequence till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you'll be putting in 2 single crochets. I'll continue with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we finish this row. I'll finish row 6, and now we have 36 stitches around. I'm just going to stop and do a row count. I'm going to pull out that last stitch so I don't lose it. When we count the rows, we're going to start here with the loop that we started off with, and that's row number 1. But when we count, we're going to count behind the marker, so we're going to count up this way. Don't count in front of the marker because it's going to throw you off. There's a little bit of a dip here, so you'll be 1 row less, it seems, if you count in front of the marker. To get an accurate row count, count behind the marker. So we're going to start here with this loop that we started off with. That's row 1, 2, we're just counting the rings, 3, 4, 5, and 6. You can see we're at the end of row 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If you count it in front of the marker, you'll see this little dip here. It's going to make 1 row less. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. But there's actually 6, because if you just move over a little bit, you can see the dip here. If you just move over a little bit, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that this line right here is going to throw you off. So always count behind the marker. And if you want to do a stitch count, remember the last stitch to count is right underneath this big loop, and it's that V. And the first stitch to count is in front of that big loop. And it's this one here. So you just count the V's. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35. And if you pull this up here, you can see the 36 right there. I'll finish row 6, and now we have 36 stitches around. Row 7 is 1 single crochet in the next 5 stitches, and then 2 single crochets into the 6th stitch, and then repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you'll be putting in 2 single crochets. So I'll do the first set with you. 1 single crochet in the first, 1 single crochet in the second, 1 in the third, 1 in the fourth, 1 in the fifth, and now 2 single crochets into the 6th stitch. 1, and back in the same stitch hole, or 2. Now we're going to repeat that, 1 in the next 5, and then 2 single crochets into the 6th. Repeat all the way around, and we'll meet back here when we land on the marker. I'll finish row 7, and now we have 42 stitches around. Row 8 is 1 single crochet in the next 13 stitches, then 2 single crochets into the next stitch, and then repeat all the way around. When you land on the marker, you'll be putting in 2 single crochets. So I'll do the first set with you. 1 in the first, 1 single crochet in the second, 1 in the third, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 1 single crochet in the 8th, 9th, 10th, 1 single crochet in the 11th, 12th, and 13th, and now 2 single crochets into the 14th stitch. 1 and back in the same stitch hole for 2. Now you're going to repeat that all the way around, and we'll meet back here when you land on the marker. Remember, when you land on the marker, you'll be putting in 2 single crochets. 1 single crochet in the next 13 stitches, then 2 single crochets into the next stitch. I'll finish row 8, and now we have 45 stitches around. Rows 9 through 16 is 1 single crochet in each one of those 45 stitches for 8 rows. So I'm going to continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of row 16. Just remember to move your marker at the end of every row. And if you don't want to keep track of your rows as you go along, keep a little notepad beside you. And every time you move this marker, put a notch on your notepad. And when you have 8 of those notches, we'll meet back here. 1 single crochet in each one of those 45 stitches for 8 rows. I'll finish row 16. Row 17 is where we start decreasing the size of this hole, and we do that by crocheting stitches together. So we're going to put 1 single crochet in the next 13 stitches, then we're going to crochet the next 2 stitches together. And of course, we'll do this row together. One single crochet in the next 13. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, and 13. And now we're going to crochet the 14th and 15th stitch together. So the next two stitches together. So we're just going to go into the next stitch, grab our yarn and pull it through, leave that loop on our hook, and go into the next stitch, grab our yarn and pull it through. Now we have three loops. Now we're going to yarn over and pull through all three loops. And you just crochet two stitches together. And now we're going to repeat that one in the next 13. And 13, and then we're going to crochet the next two stitches together. Go in, grab our yarn, pull it through, leave that loop on our hook, go into the next stitch, grab our yarn, pull it through. We now have three loops. Now we yarn over and pull through all three loops. So I'll do the next set with you again so you can see what it looks like when you land on the marker. One in the next 13. And 13, and then we're going to crochet the next two stitches together. And you can see that second stitch is going to land on the marker, so I'm just going to pull the marker out. Go in and grab my yarn, leave that loop on my hook, and go into the next stitch, grab my yarn. I have three loops, now I yarn over and pull through all three loops. And that completes row 17, and now we have 42 stitches around. Move the marker. Okay, this is for those of you who are using safety eyes with the backs. I don't use the backs on mine. I actually glue mine in. This one here, these ones aren't even in yet. And I just glue mine in. And I'm going to show you how to do that after the doll is already sewn together, all the parts are sewn in together. But those of you who want to attach the safety eyes now, now is the time to do it. And then you just count down from the rings. This is row number one. And we're going to put the eyes in between the 12th and the 13th row, so you just count down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. So in between there. So you put one there, and then I put 6 or 7 stitches in between them. Now remember, you're going to be putting a muzzle on there, and the top of the muzzle will be going just right about there. So in between the eyes, there is about 6 or 7 visible stitch holes between them. You just count the stitch holes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So if you like that placement, you put them there. If you want them closer, you just put them over one. Probably closer looks a little bit better. So 6 visible stitches between them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Moving on to row 18. I'm going to put one single crochet in the next 5 stitches, and then crochet two together, repeat all the way around until you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two stitches together. So I'll do the first set with you. One single crochet in the first, one in the second, third, fourth, and fifth stitch. And now we're going to crochet the next two stitches together. Go and grab our yarn, pull it through, leave that loop on our hook, and go into the next stitch, grab our yarn, pull it through. We have three loops, now we yarn over and pull through all three loops. Now we're just going to repeat that sequence all the way around till you land on the marker. And remember, when you land on the marker, you'll be crocheting two stitches together. One in the next 5, then crochet two stitches together. All finished row 18. I've moved my marker, and now I have 36 stitches around. Row 19 is one single crochet in the next 4 stitches, and then crochet two together. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you'll be crocheting two stitches together. So again, I'll do the first set with you. And as this hole gets smaller and smaller, you'll notice that it's quite easy to go back into the last stitch you just put in. Make sure that you stretch over a little bit to get into the first stitch of the next row. So this is the stitches that we just did here. We want to make sure that we're getting into the next row. One in the next 4. That was 1, 2, 3, and 4, and now we're going to crochet two stitches together. And now repeat that sequence all the way around till you land on the marker. And remember, when you land on a marker, you'll be crocheting two stitches together. And just pay attention to the stitches now and make sure that you're getting into the next one and not the last one that you just put in. I'll finish row 19 and I've moved my marker, and now we have 30 stitches around. Row 20 is one single crochet in the next three stitches, and then we're going to crochet two together. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you'll be crocheting two stitches together. So again, when we get into the first stitch of the next row, make sure that you don't go back into the last stitch you just put in. One in the next three. There's one, two, and three. And now we're going to crochet two stitches together. Going in, grab our yarn, pull it through, leave that loop on our hook, and go into the next stitch, grab our yarn, pull it through. We have three loops. Now we yarn over and pull through all three loops. And now we're going to repeat that sequence and keep repeating till you land on the marker. Remember, when you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two stitches together. I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of the row. I'll finish row 20, and now we have 24 stitches around. Rows 21 is one single crochet in the next two stitches, and then crochet two together. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two stitches together. So one single crochet in the next two stitches, one and two, and then crochet two stitches together. And now repeat that sequence and keep repeating all the way around, and we'll meet back here when we land on the marker. I'll finish row 21 and I've moved my marker. We now have 18 stitches around. Row 22 is one single crochet in the next four stitches, and then crochet two together. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two stitches together. So one single crochet in the next four. And then crochet two stitches together. And now repeat that all the way around till you land on the marker. Okay, I'll finish row 22, and now we have 15 stitches around. Row 23 is we're going to put two single crochets in each one of those 15 stitches for one row. So again, just make sure that you're getting into the right stitch and not going back into the last one you just put in. One single crochet in the first, and then going back in the same stitch we were just in and put another single crochet. And we're going to keep repeating that, two single crochets in each one of those 15 stitches. So I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of the row. Okay, I'll finish row 23, and now we have 30 stitches around. We're going to stop and stuff the head. So I'm just going to pull out that last stitch quite a ways so I don't lose it. In case I pull on this thread, I won't lose the stitch. So just leave it hanging like that. Okay, and go ahead and put lots of stuffing in. When you have the majority of the stuffing into the head, I'll show you how I shape the head as I go along. So as I'm pushing the stuffing down, I'm pushing the stuffing into the sides of the head. So I'm going to push down and at the same time pushing it into the sides of the head. Pushing it into the sides. I'm using my fingers to get it all in this area here, underneath the head itself. Okay, we'll move the marker. We can also add more stuffing in later on after we get a few more rows done. So moving on, rows 24 through 28 is one single crochet in each one of those 30 stitches for five rows. So I'll continue on with the pattern, and I'll meet you back here at the end of row 28. Just remember to move your marker at the end of every row. And also, if you don't want to keep track of your rows, just use a little notepad beside you, and every time you move this marker, put a notch on your notepad. When you have five of those notches, we'll meet back here. One single crochet in each one of those 30 stitches for five rows. I'll finish row 28, and I've moved my marker. Row 29 is one single crochet in the next four stitches, then two single crochets into the fifth stitch, and repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in 2 single crochets. So 1 single crochet in the first, second, third, and fourth. And now 2 single crochets into the fifth stitch. And now repeat that sequence and keep repeating, and we'll meet back here on the marker. Remember, when you land on the marker, you should be putting in 2 single crochets. 1 in the next 4, and 2 single crochets into the fifth stitch. I'll finish row 29. I've moved my marker. We now have 36 stitches around. Row 30 is 1 single crochet in the next 5 stitches, and then 2 single crochets into the next stitch. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in 2 single crochets. So 1 single crochet in the next 5. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And now 2 single crochets into the next stitch. And then we're going to repeat that sequence and keep repeating, and we'll meet back here when we land on the marker. 1 in the next 5, and then 2 single crochets into the 6th stitch. I'll finish row 30, and now we have 42 stitches around. Rows 31 through 35 is 1 single crochet in each one of those 42 stitches for 5 rows. So I'll continue with the pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of row 35. Just remember to move your marker at the end of every row. 1 single crochet in each one of those 42 stitches for 5 rows. Okay, I'll finish row 35. And now we're going to start decreasing the hole again. And for this row, row 36, we're going to put 1 single crochet in the next 5 stitches, and then we're going to crochet 2 stitches together. Repeat that sequence all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. So I'll do the first set with you. 1 single crochet in the first, second, third, fourth, and fifth. And now crochet 2 stitches together. Leave those loops on your hook and go into the next stitch. Now you have 3 loops, yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Now you're going to repeat that sequence, 1 in the next 5, and then crochet 2 together all the way around, and we'll meet back here when we land on the marker. Finished row 36, and now we have 36 stitches around. Row 37 is 1 single crochet in the next 4 stitches, and then crochet 2 together. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. So 1 single crochet in the first, 1 in the second, 1 in the third, 1 in the fourth, and now crochet 2 stitches together. Now repeat that sequence and keep repeating. We'll meet back here on the marker. Finished row 37, and now we have 30 stitches around. Row 38 is 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches, and then crochet 2 together. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. So 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches. That was 1, 2, and 3. And now crochet 2 stitches together. And now repeat that sequence, 1 in the next 3, then 2 together all the way around till you land on the marker. I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of the row. Finished row 38, and now we have 24 stitches around. Row 39 is 1 single crochet in the next 2 stitches, then crochet 2 together, repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. So 1 single crochet in the first, 1 single crochet in the second, and then crochet 2 stitches together. Now repeat that sequence, 1 in the next 2, then 2 together, all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. I'll continue with the pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of the row. I'll finish row 39, and now we have 18 stitches around. We're going to pull out the last stitch so we don't lose it, and we're going to stop and we're going to stuff the doll. So we're going to get lots of stuffing in there. When you first put the stuffing in, make sure that you get the stuffing right into the neck, because sometimes there's a hole in the stuffing in the neck, and that'll make the neck floppy. Just make sure you got all the stuffing that you need in that area, and take the time right now to put any stuffing up in this area here if you need it. So you just push all the way in and push it around with your fingers. There's going to be lots of stuffing that goes in here. And once you get the neck and the chest area filled up, when you get down in here, we're going to shape it the same way we did the head. We're going to push the stuffing into the sides, and we're going to spin the doll as we're stuffing and pushing the stuffing into the sides. It takes lots of stuffing. And we are going to stop after the next row and put more stuffing in. So we just want to make sure that we got the neck area filled in and all underneath the head filled in, the chest filled in, and the majority of the body filled in. Then we can continue on to the next row, and then we'll stop and we'll put more stuffing in. Okay, continue on to row 40. Row 40 is one single crochet and then two together, and repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you'll be crocheting two stitches together. So for this one, because we have stuffing in there, we can actually be pulling the stuffing through the stitches, so we want to make sure that we got the stuffing down and out of the way. You can squeeze the body together if you need to. I squeeze and hold it like that. Put one single crochet in the next stitch, and then crochet two together. And this row will take a little bit longer to stop and readjust as you go along. One single crochet and two together. You want to pull your stitches a little bit more tighter as well. Squeeze the doll together. Okay, so we're just going to pull up that last stitch so we don't lose it, and that finishes off row 40. Now we're going to stop and we're going to put more stuffing in there. See, I'm pushing the stuffing in. I'm going to give the bear or the bunny a fat belly. Just using the fingers to guide the stuffing in where I want it to go. Okay, now we're ready for row 41. In row 41, we're just repeating the last row. One single crochet and then two together, all the way around till you land on the marker. We can add a marker here. We'll just work this row together. So now I'm going to squeeze the doll together again, holding it down with those fingers in my thumb and crocheting around. One single crochet in the first, and then two together. And don't worry if you have a little bit of trouble coordinating your fingers, because amigurumi takes a little bit of practice to get comfortable with this, going around in small rounds and also working in a doll that's been stuffed already. So give yourself a break if you're having a hard time. It gets easier with every amigurumi that you make. One single crochet and two together. See, I'm squeezing the doll together. I don't want to pull any stuffing through those stitches. And we're done. That finishes off row 41, and now we have 8 stitches around. You can break free, leave a little bit of a tail for closing up the gap and also hiding the yarn tail inside the body. So we're going to pull the yarn tail through this big loop. Just pull it through and pull it tight. Now you want to get any more stuffing in there that you need. And this is where, when I'm pushing the stuffing in, I'm going to push it up and around the bottom of this body. I'm just using my finger to get it all up in this area here. Take your time to stuff in shape while you stuff. It gives a nice finishing touch to your doll if you take the time to do these little things now. Okay, so we're going to thread our yarn needle and we're going to take the end of the yarn, and instead of pushing the end through the eye of the needle that risks spraying the end, we're just going to bend it over and push the bend through. And now we're going to weave in and out of these remaining 8 stitches. So going in and then out the next stitch over, and then in and out. Okay, so we're going to pull on this yarn tail, but before we do that, I see I just need a little bit of more stuffing in there just to fill up that stuffing gap. So that looks pretty good. And if you need any more stuffing, do it now. Okay, that looks pretty good. So now I'm going to pull on this yarn tail, and that just closed up that gap. Now I'm going to knot this off right beside there. I'm going to pull the yarn tail through that loop and pull it tight. And that just knotted it off. Now I need to hide the yarn tail inside the body. I can't just cut it free because it'll eventually work itself free and I'll get a hole in my stuffy. So just bring the yarn needle down and out through a stitch on the side of the body. Just pull on it. Now pull on it slightly and cut. Now the yarn tail has sprung back in the body and it's hidden away. So now we're going to make the ears, and for this part of the tutorial I'm using this color right here because I'm making this bunny. The ears are the same, whatever color you choose to use. Okay, now we're making the ears, and we make 2 of these, and we start right here, and we work our way down to the bottom of the ear. Row 1 is a loop with 6 stitches in it, and again you can add in a marker into the last stitch you just put in, or just wait till you finish the end of row 2 and we'll add the marker then. You can crochet the starting yarn tail into the second row just by crocheting around it, or leave it hanging and we'll tuck it into the piece as we work along. Row 2 is 2 single crochets in each one of those 6 stitches. So there's our first stitch of the row. Make sure that you have 2 loops of that stitch on top of your hook. Go ahead and put your single crochet, then go back into the same stitch and put your other single crochet. There was 2 single crochets into the first stitch. Now we're going to go into the second one and put 2 single crochets. Now into the third stitch, 2 single crochets. Now into the fourth, 2 single crochets. Now into the fifth, 2 single crochets. And last time into the sixth stitch, 2 single crochets. And there's the end of row 2, and now we have 12 stitches around. I'll go ahead and add my marker. Row 3 is 1 single crochet into the first stitch, 2 single crochets into the second, then repeat that sequence all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in 2 single crochets. I'll do the first set with you, 1 single crochet into the first, and then 2 single crochets into the second stitch. 1, and back in the same stitch, and put 2. Now we're going to repeat that sequence. 1 single crochet in the first, 2 single crochets into the second, 1 single crochet in the next, 2 single crochets into the stitch after that. Keep repeating, and when you land on the marker, you'll be putting in 2 single crochets. So I'll continue with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we finish this row. Finish row 3, now we have 18 stitches around. Row 4 is 1 single crochet in the next 5 stitches, then 2 single crochets into the 6th stitch. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you'll be putting in 2 single crochets. I'll do the first set with you. 1 single crochet into the first, 1 single crochet into the second, 1 into the third, 1 into the fourth, 1 into the fifth, and now 2 single crochets into the 6th stitch. 1 and 2. And now repeat that sequence, 1 in the next 5, and then 2 single crochets into the 6th stitch. Repeat all the way around, and when you land on the marker, you'll be putting in 2 single crochets. I'll finish row 4, and now we have 21 stitches around, and I'm just stopping to show you how the piece is folding up on itself. It'll naturally do that. So we just want to turn it right side. The part where the starting yarn tail is coming out of, we're going to push that inward. And there's the right side, and there's the wrong side. Right side, wrong side. Now we can add our marker. Finished row 4, now we have 21 stitches around. Row 5 is 1 single crochet in the next 6 stitches, then 2 single crochets into the 7th. Repeat that sequence all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you'll be putting in 2 single crochets. So I'll do the first set with you. 1 single crochet in the first, 1 in the second, 1 in the third, 1 in the fourth, 1 in the fifth, 1 in the 6th, and now 2 single crochets into the 7th stitch. 1, and back in the same stitch, and put 2. Now repeat that sequence, 1 in the next 6, and then 2 single crochets into the 7th stitch. When you land on the marker, you'll be putting in 2 single crochets. I'll continue on the pattern, I'll meet you back here when we land on that marker. I'll finish row 5, and now we have 24 stitches around. I've moved my marker. Row 6 and 7 is 1 single crochet in each one of those 24 stitches for 2 rows. So I'll continue on the pattern, I'll meet you back here at the end of row 7. Just remember to move your marker at the end of every row. 1 single crochet in each one of those 24 stitches for 2 rows. I'll finish row 7, and I've moved my marker. Row 8 is 1 single crochet in the next 6 stitches, and then crochet 2 stitches together. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. So I'll do the first set with you. 1 single crochet in the first, 1 in the second, 1 in the third, 1 in the fourth, 1 in the fifth, 1 single crochet in the sixth, and now crochet the next 2 stitches together. Go in and grab your yarn, pull it through, leave that loop on your hook, go into the next stitch, grab your yarn and pull it through. Now you have 3 loops, yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. And then you're going to repeat that sequence, 1 in the next 6 stitches, and then crochet 2 stitches together. Repeat all the way around. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. So I'll continue on with the pattern, I'll meet you back here at the end of the row. At the end of row 8, and now we have 21 stitches around. Rows 9 and 10 is 1 single crochet in each one of those 21 stitches for 2 rows. So I'll continue on with the pattern, I'll meet you back here at the end of row 10. Just remember to move your marker at the end of every row. And when you look here, as we start decreasing, you'll see how that pulls up here. Make sure you're getting into the first stitch of the next row and you're not going back into the last stitches that you just crocheted together. These ones you just worked in. You want to stretch over a little bit and make sure you're getting into the first stitch of the next row. 1 single crochet in each one of those 21 stitches for 2 rows. Okay, at the end of row 10, and I've moved my marker, row 11 is 1 single crochet in the next 5 stitches, then crochet 2 together, repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. I'll do the first set with you. 1 single crochet in the first, 1 in the second, 1 in the third, 1 in the fourth, 1 single crochet in the 5th, and now crochet the next 2 stitches together. Go and grab your yarn, pull it through, leave that loop on your hook, and go into the next stitch, grab your yarn, pull it through, Now you have three loops, yarn over and pull through all three loops. Now repeat that sequence, one in the next five stitches, then crochet two stitches together. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land at the marker, you should be crocheting two stitches together. I'll continue with the pattern, I'll meet you back here at the end of the row. At the end of row 11, and I've moved my marker, we now have 18 stitches around. Rows 12 and 13 is one single crochet in each one of those 18 stitches for two rows. So I'll continue with the pattern, I'll meet you back here at the end of row 13. Just remember to move your marker at the end of every row. One single crochet in each one of those 18 stitches for two rows. At the end of row 13, and I've moved my marker, row 14 is one single crochet in the next four stitches, then crochet two together. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two stitches together. I'll do the first set with you. One single crochet in the first, one in the second, one in the third, one in the fourth, and now crochet the next two stitches together. Now repeat that sequence all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two stitches together. I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. At the end of row 14, I've moved my marker. We now have 15 stitches around. Rows 15 and 16 is one single crochet in each one of those 15 stitches for two rows. So I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of row 16. Just remember to move your marker at the end of every row. Also remember that it's very easy to go back into the last stitches that you just crocheted, so make sure you're getting into the first stitch of the next row. One single crochet in each one of those 15 stitches for two rows. At the end of row 16, I've moved my marker. Row 17 is one single crochet in the next three stitches, then crochet two together, repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two stitches together. I'll do the first set with you. One single crochet in the first, one in the second, one in the third, and now crochet two stitches together. Now repeat that sequence all the way around till you land on the marker. Finished row 17, and now we have 12 stitches around. I've moved my marker. Rows 18 and 19 is one single crochet in each one of those 12 stitches for two rows. So I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of row 19. All finished row 19. Now we can finish off. Leave a nice long tail for sewing. You're going to use this tail to sew the ear to the head. Pull that yarn tail through that big loop and pull it tight. So you leave the ears unstuffed. You can put in pipe cleaners, which would make the ears poseable and will also help them stand up. It's not completely necessary, so if you don't have any, don't worry about it. These ears here don't have any inside. They stand up okay. I do prefer the pipe cleaners inside though. Okay, so I'm using these two pipe cleaners here. Now, I've run out of pipe cleaners. I'm just using what I have on hand. I would use a similar color to the yarn that you use to make your bunny with. So you just, I take two pipe cleaners and I just kind of twist them together and then I loosely bend them over and I'm just going to push that bend all the way to the end of the bunny ear. So to keep the pipe cleaners in place, what I do is I stitch in here, here, and here. So I just take a length of yarn, the same color as the ear of course, and I'm just going to go in and out. Pull one of the yarn tails through and leave one of them hanging inside. So I'm just going to wrap around the pipe cleaner. I'm going to make sure that I've wrapped around in there. So when I go back in, I'm going to be going in through stitch holes. There we go. In and out through stitch holes. There, I've caught the pipe cleaner inside. Now I'm going to carry this yarn tail up here. I'm just carrying it. I'm going to carry it again, so I'm going back in the same stitch hole I just came out of. I'm going to go up right through the top part. Okay, so now I'm going to go in through the other side, out through a stitch hole, going back in, this time wrapping the yarn. Can't see, but you're going to have to feel underneath that pipe cleaner. And then in, back through a stitch hole, and then up and out. There, I've just wrapped around the pipe cleaner inside there. And I'm going to go back in the same stitch hole I just came out of, carrying the yarn till to this side, and doing the same thing. Okay, I'm going to carry this down. I'm going to do the same thing down here. There we go. Now I can just knot these two yarn tails off. Now I'm going to cut the excess pipe cleaner off. So now we're assured the pipe cleaner will stay around the edges of the ear, and those ears are now poseable. Now we're going to make the muzzle, and we're going to whip stitch the nose into place once we're done the muzzle. Row 1 is a loop with 6 stitches. Here you can add in a marker if you'd like to into the last stitch you just put in, or wait till the end of the second row to put in the marker. You can also get rid of this starting yarn tail by holding along the edge and crocheting it into row 2, or you can just leave it hanging and we'll work it into our piece as we work along. I'm just going to leave it hanging, and I'm going to leave the marker off until the end of row 2. Row 2 is 2 single crochets in each one of those 6 stitches. So go into the first stitch and put your 1 single crochet, and then back into the same stitch and put another crochet. And there was 2 single crochets into the first stitch. Now we're going to repeat that. 1 single crochet into the second stitch, and going back in the same stitch hole and put another single crochet. And there was 2 single crochets into the second stitch. Now into the third. 1 and 2. Now into the fourth. 1 and 2. Now into the fifth stitch, 1 and 2, and last time into the sixth stitch, 1 and 2. That's the end of row 2, and now we have 12 stitches around. Now we'll add in our marker. Row 3 is 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches, then 2 single crochets into the 4th stitch. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you'll be putting in 2 single crochets. I'll do the first set with you. 1 single crochet into the first, 1 single crochet into the second, 1 single crochet into the 3rd stitch, and now 2 single crochets into the 4th. 1 and 2. Now we're going to repeat that. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in 2 single crochets. 1 in the next 3, and then 2 single crochets into the 4th stitch. I finished row 3, and you can see the piece is starting to fold up on itself. So I want to turn it right side. So where the starting yarn tail is coming out of, I'm just going to push that inward. So this is the right side, and this is the wrong side. Now I'll add in my marker. And that was the end of row 3, and then we have 15 stitches around. Row 4 is 1 single crochet in each one of those 15 stitches for 1 row. So I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in 1 single crochet. Okay, I'll finish row 4. Now this part isn't in the written pattern, but I usually slip stitch the next stitch when I'm finishing off a muzzle. So let's do that here. Slip stitch, you just go into the next stitch like you normally would. Grab your yarn, pull it through. And instead of yarning over, just pull the first loop through the second loop. And that just finishes off that edge nicely. Now we're going to break free, and we're going to leave a nice long tail for sewing. You're going to use this tail to sew the muzzle to the head. Now you just pull the yarn tail through that loop and pull it tight. Now this starting yarn tail, we can just cut up a bit shorter and just leave that tucked inside the muzzle. Now we can whip stitch the nose in place. Okay, and I use embroidery thread, and it comes in packages like this. You can use yarn if you'd like. So we're just going to thread the thread tail through the yarn needle. And you can make the nose as big or as small as you like. I go through the loop that we started off with, bring it through, bring the one thread tail through, and leave the other one hanging in the back. And I pull quite a bit through, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to wrap. Instead of going back and forth, I'm just going to fold this over, and I'm going to wrap around. So I'm going to wrap around these two rings, this one and this one. And what I do first is I just make a small V, just as a guide. Okay, and now I'm just going to keep wrapping and filling in this V. And you're going to wrap many times. Alright, I'm done with the nose, and I wrap quite a few times. Now I'll just put a line for the finishing it off. I can double up on that line and make it more pronounced. And you can add in a mouth if you'd like. You could embroider a little mouth there. I just leave the line. Now you just cut these thread tails and knot them off in the back. Okay, now we're going to make the arms, and I'm using the same color as I used for the body and the head. And we're going to start right here at the bottom of the arm, or the hand, and work our way to the top of the arm. Row 1 is a loop with 6 stitches. Here you can add in a marker, if you'd like to, into the last stitch you just put in, or wait till the end of the second row to put in the marker. You can also get rid of this starting yarn tail by holding along the edge and crocheting it into row 2. Or you can just leave it hanging and we'll work it into our piece as we work along. I'm just going to leave it hanging, and I'm going to leave the marker off until the end of row 2. Row 2 is 2 single crochets in each one of those 6 stitches. So go into the first stitch and put your 1 single crochet, and then back into the same stitch and put another crochet. And there was 2 single crochets into the first stitch. Now we're going to repeat that. 1 single crochet into the second stitch, and going back in the same stitch hole, and put another single crochet. And there was 2 single crochets into the second stitch. Now into the third. 1 and 2. Now into the fourth. 1 and 2. Now into the fifth stitch. 1 and 2. And last time, into the sixth stitch, 1 and 2. That's the end of row 2, and now we have 12 stitches around. Now we'll add in our marker. Row 3 is 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches, then 2 single crochets into the fourth stitch. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you'll be putting in 2 single crochets. I'll do the first set with you. 1 single crochet into the first, 1 single crochet into the second, 1 single crochet into the third stitch, and now 2 single crochets into the fourth. 1 and 2. Now we're going to repeat that. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in 2 single crochets. 1 in the next 3, and then 2 single crochets into the fourth stitch. I finished row 3. And you can see the piece is starting to fold up on itself. So I want to turn it right side. So where the starting yarn tail is coming out of, I'm just going to push that inward. So this is the right side. And this is the wrong side. Now I'll add in my marker. And that was the end of row 3, and then we have 15 stitches around. Row 4 is one single crochet in each one of those 15 stitches for one row. So I'll continue with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in one single crochet. I'll finish row 4. Row 5 is one single crochet in the next 3 stitches, then crochet 2 stitches together. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. So one single crochet in the first, one in the second, one in the third, and now crochet 2 stitches together. And then repeat that and keep repeating till we land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. I'll finish row 5 and now we have 12 stitches around. I'm just going to cut up this starting yarn tail a bit shorter. I'm just going to tuck it inside the hand and get it out of my way. I've moved my marker. Row 6 is one single crochet in each one of those 12 stitches for one row. So I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. I'll finish row 6. Row 7 is one single crochet in the next 4 stitches and then crochet 2 together. And repeat one more time, and when you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. So one in the next 4, that was 1, 2, 3, 4. And now crochet 2 stitches together. And I'll just finish off this row with you because we're almost there. 1, 2, 3, 4. And now 2 together, and you can see that second stitch is going to land on the marker, so I'll pull the marker out and crochet those 2 stitches together. And that ended row 7, and now we have 10 stitches around. Move my marker. Row 8 through 16 is one single crochet in each one of those 10 stitches for 9 rows. So I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of row 16 and we'll finish off the arm together. One single crochet in each one of those 10 stitches for 9 rows. Just remember to move your marker at the end of every row. Okay, I'll finish row 16. So I'm going to finish off. I'm going to leave a tail for sewing because I'm going to use this yarn tail to sew the arm to the body. I'm going to pull that yarn tail through that big loop and pull it tight. And I'm going to stuff the hand and use a stuffing stick if you have it. If not, then just use the back end of a pen or a pencil. Okay, for the arm, you can just stuff the arm and leave it just with stuffing. Or you can put in pipe cleaners. Now, I would normally use white pipe cleaners, but I don't have any on hand. I've run out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take 2 colored ones here. I'm just going to bend them over. I'm going to twist them over. And because if I put this in here, those will show through. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to wrap my yarn around them real quick here. Okay, I'm going to knot this off. So now that color won't show through the yarn because I'm going to stuff the arm as well. I'm just going to push that in there. I'm trying to get that bend down into the stuffing area. There we go. Okay, I'm going to cut this excess off. You don't need to put pipe cleaners in if you don't want to. It just gives a little bit of poseability to the arm. So I'm just going to put a little bit of stuffing around the pipe cleaner, just on both sides. Just working the stuffing it around the pipe cleaner so the pipe cleaner is in the middle. Okay, now we're going to make the legs. Now this part of that tutorial that I'm using this color right here. You of course follow along with whatever color you use to make your bunny with. Row 1 is a loop with 6 stitches in it, and again you can add in a marker into the last stitch you just put in, or just wait till you finish the end of row 2 and we'll add the marker then. You can crochet the starting yarn tail into the second row just by crocheting around it, or leave it hanging and we'll tuck it into the piece as we work along. Row 2 is 2 single crochets in each one of those 6 stitches. So there's our first stitch of the row. Make sure that you have 2 loops of that stitch on top of your hook. Go ahead and put your single crochet, then go back into the same stitch and put your other single crochet. There was 2 single crochets into the first stitch. Now we're going to go into the second one and put 2 single crochets. Now into the third stitch, 2 single crochets. Now into the fourth, 2 single crochets. Now into the fifth, 2 single crochets. And last time into the sixth stitch, 2 single crochets. And there's the end of row 2, and now we have 12 stitches around. I'll go ahead and add my marker. Row 3 is 1 single crochet into the first stitch, 2 single crochets into the second, then repeat that sequence all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in 2 single crochets. I'll do the first set with you. 1 single crochet into the first, and then 2 single crochets into the second stitch. 1, and back in the same stitch, and put 2. Now we're going to repeat that sequence. 1 single crochet in the first, 2 single crochets into the second. 1 single crochet in the next, 2 single crochets into the stitch after that. Keep repeating, and when you land on the marker, you'll be putting in 2 single crochets. So I'll continue with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we finish this row. Finished row 3, and now we have 18 stitches around. Row 4 is 1 single crochet in the first, 1 in the second, then 2 single crochets into the third. Repeat that sequence all the way around. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in 2 single crochets. I'll do the first set with you. 1 single crochet in the first, 1 single crochet in the second, and now 2 single crochets into the third stitch. And now repeat that. 1 single crochet in the first, 1 in the second, 2 in the third. All the way around, when you land on the marker, you should be putting in 2 single crochets. I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. I'll finish row 4. Now we have 24 stitches around. Row 5 is 1 single crochet in the first 3 stitches, then 2 single crochets into the 4th stitch. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in 2 single crochets. 1 single crochet in the first, 1 single crochet in the second, 1 single crochet in the third, now 2 single crochets into the 4th stitch. Now repeat that all the way around, and we'll meet back here when we land on the marker. We're all finished row 5, and now we have 30 stitches around. And remember, if the piece is folding up on itself, you want to be working on the right side, so make sure you fold it to the right side. Right side, wrong side. Row 6 and 7 is 1 single crochet in each one of those 30 stitches for 2 rows. So I'll continue on with the pattern, and I'll meet you back here at the end of row 7. Just remember to move your marker at the end of every row. 1 single crochet in each one of those 30 stitches for 2 rows. I'll finish row 7 and I've moved my marker. Row 8 is 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches, then crochet 2 stitches together. Repeat that sequence all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. So I'll do the first set with you. 1 single crochet in the first, 1 in the second, 1 in the third, and now crochet 2 stitches together. Go ahead and grab your yarn, pull it through, leave that loop on your hook, go into the next stitch, grab your yarn, pull it through. Now you have 3 loops, yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Now repeat that sequence, 1 in the next 3, then crochet 2 together all the way around. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. I'll continue on with the pattern, I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. I'll finish row 8, and now we have 24 stitches around. Row 9 is one single crochet in the first, then crochet 2 together. Repeat that sequence 6 times, then put one single crochet in the last 6 stitches. So that means we're going to be repeating this sequence over 18 stitches. But if you don't want to count in your head as you're going along, you can just count up to 18 stitches and mark it off. Then you can do that sequence, one in the first, and then crochet 2 together, one in the first, and crochet 2 together all the way around until you land on that first marker. So we can count off 18 stitches here. Here's my last stitch I just put in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. And that's where we know our first sequence is going to end. So now we'll just carry on. One single crochet, then crochet 2 together. One single crochet in the first, then crochet the next 2 stitches together. One single crochet, then crochet 2 together. One single crochet 2 together. And then last time, one single crochet. And I'm going to crochet the next 2 together. It's going to land on that marker, so I'll pull it out. And we're finished off that sequence. And now we'll put one single crochet in the rest of the stitches to the next marker. One in the first, second, third, fourth, fifth. And that last one's going to land on the marker, so I'll pull it out. And that ends row 9, and now we have 18 stitches around. I'm going to move my marker. Row 10 is one single crochet in each one of those 18 stitches for one row. So I'll continue with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. Finished row 10. We still have 18 stitches around, and I've moved my marker. Row 11 is one single crochet in the first, then crochet 2 together. Repeat that sequence 4 times, then one single crochet in the last 6 stitches. And again, we can mark off the stitch that we're going to end on, and we are working over the next 12 stitches. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So mark that one off. So now we can do the sequence, one in the first, then 2 together, up to that marker. When we land on the marker, we'll be crocheting 2 stitches together. One single crochet in the first, then crochet 2 together. And last time, one single crochet, and we're going to crochet 2 together. It's going to land on that marker, so I'll pull it out, and crochet 2 together. And now put one single crochet in the next 6 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the last one, pull out the marker, and 6. And that's the end of row 11, and now we have 14 stitches around. I'm going to move my marker. Rows 12 to 22 is one single crochet in each one of those 14 stitches for 11 rows. Now in the pattern I say to stuff the foot right now. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put 2 rows of single crochets in, and then we'll stuff the foot together. So let's go ahead and do that. Put one single crochet in each one of those 14 stitches for 2 rows, and then we'll meet back here and we'll stuff the foot. Okay, I just put 2 rows of single crochets in. Now I'm going to pull up my last stitch so I don't lose it. I'm just going to leave it hanging. And if you push out the yarn here, you can see that foot is already has somewhat of a shape. So here's the front of the foot here. We want to stuff the foot accordingly. We don't want to overstuff the foot and make it a round ball. You want the foot to have some shape to it. So push the stuffing down into the toes. And I'm pushing the heel out with my thumb. So you can see how that kind of shaped the foot more there. So And here's my other leg and foot is already done, this one here. You can see how I've shaped it. So you just use your fingers to push the stuffing around and also to shape out the foot. So that's enough for now. We can continue out the pattern, then we can stop and stuff the leg. Add our marker. So there we put two rows of single crochets, so we know we're at the end of row 13. So now we'll continue on. We'll put one single crochet in each one of those 14 stitches for 9 more rows. So I'll continue out the pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of row 22. Remember to move your marker at the end of every row. And if you don't want to keep track, you can put a little notepad beside you, and every time you move that marker, put a notch on your notepad. Okay, I'm at the end of row 22, so I'm just going to pull up my last stitch so I don't lose it. Just leave it hanging. And we're going to stuff the leg. And if you need to, you can use a stuffing stick, but the back end of a pencil works great. It's right about there. Looks pretty good. So now what we're going to do is single crochet to the side of the leg, because we want to close up the top. We're going to make the top flat. So when the leg sits, this top part here, this is the toe, top of the toe, and this part is going to be sewn to the bottom of the bunny. So when the legs are sewn on, the foot sits upward. So we want to crochet to the side of the leg. I'm on the back there, so I'm just going to put single crochet the next few stitches here till I get to the side of the leg. There I am. Okay, now we're going to squeeze the top of the leg together, and we're just going to single crochet right through both sides. Now if you can't, if it's awkward, you can chain one, then you can move your hook a little easier. Single crochet through both sides of the leg. Okay, and we're going to do that all the way across. Okay, I'm at the end, and I'm going to chain one and turn the leg, and now single crochet across one more time. And there we go, we've closed up the leg and created a little flap. Now we can break free. Leave a tail for sewing. You're going to use this tail to sew the leg to the body. Pull that yarn tail through that loop and pull it tight. Okay, you can make a solid tail, and I'll insert a clip from my bear tutorial, and because the tail is made the exact same way, or you can make the bunny tail. So I'm going to show you how to make the bunny tail right now. If you don't want to make the bunny tail, then just skip this segment and head into the next one, and I'll show you how to make a solid tail. Okay, so before we start making the pom-pom, we need to cut a length of yarn. I don't know, about 18 inches long, I guess. 18, 2 feet long. And just set that aside. We're going to use that to tie off our pom-pom when we're finished wrapping here. And we're just going to use our fingers to make the pom-pom. We're going to lay the yarn just like that and hold it with your thumb and then start wrapping. And don't wrap so tight that you won't be able to pull this off your fingers when you're done. And also you don't want to lose circulation, of course. And we're just going to keep wrapping like this for about 75-80 times. Okay, I finished wrapping. I actually didn't count. I just kind of guessed my way along. So I'm just going to cut that free there. Now pull this off the fingers, but don't let it unravel. Then grab your yarn tie, yarn strand, and wrap it around. Now we're going to tie this off, but when you go to make your knot, wrap this around once and then twice, and that'll just keep it from slipping when you pull it tight. You can pull it tight and let it go. And pull it as tight as you can without breaking that yarn. And now we're just going to cut through these loops. You want to get something to catch all the yarn with. Okay, so we're just going to cut through these loops. Don't cut through these yarn ties here, because we're going to use these yarn ties to sew the bunny tail to your bunny. Just cut through those loops. Okay, and now we're just going to trim this up. Go ahead and trim it, and you'll see it start taking shape as you trim. Okay, so I just trimmed it up until I had myself a nice little pom-pom, and we'll use these yarn tails here to sew the pom-pom to the bunny. Okay, now we're going to make the tail, and we start right here with this loop, and we work our way this way. Row 1 is a loop with 6 stitches. Here you can add in a marker, if you'd like to, into the last stitch you just put in, or wait till the end of the second row to put in the marker. You can also get rid of this starting yarn tail by holding along the edge and crocheting it into row 2. Or you can just leave it hanging and we'll work it into our piece as we work along. I'm just going to leave it hanging and I'm going to leave the marker off until the end of row 2. Row 2 is 2 single crochets in each one of those 6 stitches. So go into the first stitch and put your 1 single crochet, and then back into the same stitch and put another crochet. And there was 2 single crochets into the first stitch. Now we're going to repeat that. 1 single crochet into the second stitch, and going back in the same stitch hole and put another single crochet. And there was 2 single crochets into the second stitch. Now into the third. 1 and 2. Now into the fourth. 1 and 2. Now into the fifth stitch. 1 and 2. And last time into the sixth stitch. 1 and 2. That's the end of row 2, and now we have 12 stitches around. Now we'll add in our marker. Row 3 is 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches, then 2 single crochets into the 4th stitch. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you'll be putting in 2 single crochets. I'll do the first set with you. 1 single crochet into the 1st, 1 single crochet into the 2nd, 1 single crochet into the 3rd stitch, and now 2 single crochets into the 4th. 1 and 2. Now we're going to repeat that. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in 2 single crochets. 1 in the next 3, and then 2 single crochets into the 4th stitch. I finished row 3, and you can see the piece is starting to fold up on itself. So I want to turn it right side. So where the starting yarn tail is coming out of, I'm just going to push that inward. So this is the right side, and this is the wrong side. Now I'll add in my marker. And that was the end of row 3, and then we have 15 stitches around. Row 4 is 1 single crochet in each one of those 15 stitches for 1 row. So I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in 1 single crochet. I'll finish row 4. Row 5 is 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches, then crochet 2 stitches together. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. So 1 single crochet in the 1st, 1 in the 2nd, 1 in the 3rd, and now crochet 2 stitches together. And then repeat that and keep repeating till we land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. I'll finish row 5, and now we have 12 stitches around. We're going to stop now and break free. We need a nice long tail for sewing. I'm going to use this tail to sew the actual tail to the body. Now pull the yarn tail through that big loop and pull tight. And we will stuff this tail and we'll wait until we're ready to sew it to the body. Okay, now we're going to sew on the legs. Now the bunny legs are sewn quite close to the very front. And I just find that that helps the bunny sit very nicely. Even with the dress on, it sits really nice. And I find that the best placement for the legs. You can, however, put the legs any place that you want to, but this will be really nice to be sitting in a chair or on a bed or wherever you want to sit the bunny at. So I've already sewn one leg on, and very simple, just go ahead and thread your yarn needle. Now I set them side by side, so the corner of this leg is going to overlap this one just a bit. Sometimes when I'm sewing these on, I will put them in a V and sew them that way, but for the bunny I kind of preferred them side by side, so when they stand up they're more side by side instead of spread apart. Again, that's just preference, and you can sew it any way you want to. Okay, so I'm just going to lay that flap right on the front of the bunny there, and I'm just going to sew, whip stitch this edge to the body itself. So I'm just going to go into the body and then back up right through the flap of the leg on the very front edge. Into the body and then back up all the way across. Okay, so the back of the flap is sewn in, but you can see it's falling down further than this leg. So to fix that, we're just going to sew the same way, but a little closer in, right along here. And again, just back and forth with the stitching. We'll see how that looks now. That looks pretty good. Now when the bunny sits, it'll sit really nicely on its own. Okay, so now I'll just bring this yarn tail out to where the other one is hanging. I'm going through stitch holes. So I just came out of a stitch hole. I'm going to go right back in the same stitch hole I just came out of. Go over here where the other one is hanging. I'll knot these two off. I'll cut them up shorter and push the knot into the body. Okay, I've already sewn my arms in place, but I'm going to insert a clip that's going to show you how to sew the arms on from a previous doll tutorial, because the arms are sewn on the exact same way. It'll just save me some filming. But you can see where I put mine here. So I'll go ahead and I'll insert that clip and you can sew the arms on. Okay, now we're sewing the arms on. And you can see I sewed the top of the arm one ring down below that neck. And you want the arms, go ahead and thread your yarn needle. I'm going to place it on the body and make sure I'm happy with how they're placed. So now I'm just going to whip stitch the top of this arm to this ring right here. Going back into the body and immediately back up and through the top edge of the arm. Into the body and immediately back up to the edge of the arm. So that's all there is to that. Now that top edge is sewn to the body. So what I'll do is I'll just put a stitch here on this one side and one on this side, just to hold the arm down. I'm going to go into the body, coming up on the other side. Okay, I'm right there. So I'm just going to go on the edge of this arm, just catching the edge of this arm, and bring the needle down into the body and onto the other side. So you can see that just kind of stitches the arm down so it's not flaring outward. Okay, and I think that's about it. So I'll bring this yarn tail now where this other one is coming out of. I'll knot these two off. I'll cut them up shorter. And then I'll just push that knot into the body. Now we'll sew on the bunny tail. I'm going to give you a little tip here that I've started doing with these pom-pom tails, because you can sew them in, but they're always a little bit loose no matter how much you sew them in. So what I do is I add a little drop of glue underneath the tail before I sew off the yarn tails, and that helps the tails stay very sturdy and securely on there. And hot glue will work, tacky glue will work, fabric glue will work. I use Fabric Fusion. It comes in a pen applicator, and it's a great thing to have on hand if you work with yarn a lot. Okay, so we're just going to thread our one yarn tail. You can see a band-aid here. Yesterday I was making after I made the pom-pom tail, I went and did something in the house with the kids, and I ended up cutting myself pretty bad, so I had to stop filming, and now there's a big ugly band-aid to look at. So I'll thread one of the yarn tails, and I know exactly where I want to put that bunny tail. So I'm just going to bring my yarn right down and just come up right close to where the bunny tail will be sitting. And same with this one here. And I'm going to come up right beside where that first yarn tail is coming out. I'm not coming through the same stitch hole, I'm coming right beside it. So before I do anything else, and now I'm going to add in some glue just underneath the middle of that bunny tail. And now I can knot these two off and pull them tight. And now I'm just going to leave that as it is. Now I'll take these yarn tails, I'm going to go right back into the body and carry the yarn tail out somewhere else. So if you didn't use glue, you'll have to sew the bunny tail in. So you take one of these yarn tails and go up through the bunny tail and then back down, and then knot them off and then hide the yarn tails inside the body. Okay, I'm going to take this and go right out. Pull on these yarn tails and snip. Now those have sprung back in the body and you can't see them. So I'll just let that glue dry, and I won't be messing around with this bunny tail at all. I'm going to let that glue completely dry, and once it's completely dry, give it an hour or so, you'll see that this bunny tail is securely on there and it's not going anywhere. Okay, now we're going to put the tail on, and the tail does get stuffed. Now if it's too hard to stuff it now, you can partially sew it to the body and then push the stuffing in there with a pencil after. I'm just going to put it on there. I'm going to put lots of pins in here. I'm pushing them in and down on a slant, so when I sew around, I can sew around, leave the pins in there, and I won't hit the stem of the pin. So just going in on a slant. Okay, and that's lots of pins, and that just holds it in place for me, and it won't move around as I'm sewing around the tail. So I'm just going to bring my yarn needle in as close to the tail edge as I can get it, and then come up somewhere else that's comfortable for the needle to come through. Make sure you're coming through a stitch hole. You're going to go back in the same hole you just came out of. I'm going to go over here on this side. Come up as close as I can to the tail, close to the edge as I can. Okay, I'm going to go back in, catching the bottom stitches of that tail. And I'll come up on this side now. And don't pull it so tight, you see it's altering the shape of the tail there, so I'm just going to reach in there and pull it back out. So I just want it snug, I don't want to pull it all too tight. So I'm going to go back in, and then I'm going to come up on this side now. I forgot to show you, once you sew the tail partially on and you need to stuff it some more, then just look for a little gap or leave a little gap there. I forgot I was going to do this, so I don't have a very big gap. There's a little one here. I'll just put the stuffing there, and then I'll use the back end of a pencil or a stuffing stick and just push it in there. And make sure that you get it evenly around. Just use your stick to shape the tail out. There we go. and then you can continue sewing around. Okay, once your tail is sewn all the way around, there's no gaps anywhere, then just bring the yarn tail up somewhere near the edge there. Just gonna wrap around one of the stitches, go through that loop and pull it tight, and that just knotted off that yarn tail. Now you just bring this into the body and bury the yarn tail. Pull on it slightly and cut. Okay, now we'll sew in the bunny ears. I'm just going to show you the placement here. So there's a loop that we started off with, the top of the head. So the bunny ears are placed on either side, about two or three rows over on each side. Placement is completely up to you, of course. Okay, so you want to pin them in place before you sew anything in place, and set the bunny back and look at it, make sure you're happy with how they look, and then sew it in. So this one's done. I'm going to pin the other one in. Thread your yarn tail. Now the first bunny ear went in, and I've just left the yarn tail hanging here, and I'm going to knot it off with this other one when I'm done. Now I used to sew these along the edge, and then turn around and then sew along the other edge, and that takes a while to do. But for this last bunny, I actually did something different, and it works out a little bit faster. So just bring your yarn tail right in close, and then go right across to the other side of the corner of the bunny ear. Bring it up, catch that bottom stitch there, and go back in and out through the back of the head. So both corners are now sewn in. I'm going to go back in the same hole I just came out of, and I'm going to come up right close to the edge of the ear. Now I'm going to go right through the bottom edge of the ear. I'm going to the very bottom edge of those stitches, right through to the other side. Now bring the yarn tail down into the head, and then back up on the other side, right close as I can get it, to the bunny ear. And now I'll go right back through again, both sides. Bring it through, and then again, right back down into the head, and up behind the ear, as close as to the ear as I can get it. I'll go back in, right through the other side. So I'm just wrapping the bottom of the ear to the head. So this works out a little bit quicker. So the trick is, you don't want to see stitches all around your ear. So you want to get the stitches coming up and going down as close to the ear as you can get them. So there I go, the ears are sewn in. And of course you want to make sure that the corners are down, because that'll be noticeable. So if your corners are up at all, just go back in and wrap around the corner and then go back out again. And just make sure that there's no gaps anywhere in the ear when you look around. Okay, so I'll bring this yarn tail now out where the other one is hanging. Make sure they're coming through the same stitch hole. Knot these two yarn tails off. Cut them up a bit shorter. And then push that knot into the back of the head. All that's left now is the muzzle and the eyes. And because this bunny is a modification from my last bear pattern, I'm going to insert a clip that will show you how to do the muzzle and then the eyes, because they're done the exact same way and they're put on the exact same row count, and there's the same distance between the eyes, so there's no difference there. So I'll let you watch those clips and get the face put on your bunny. Okay, now we're gonna sew in the muzzle. Now I've just stuffed it a little bit. You don't need to worry about stuffing it too much, because we can always stuff more after we get it partially sewn to the face. So just put a little bit in there. You might want to just leave the stuffing out of yours for now. It's a little bit awkward. Now in the written pattern I say put the muzzle on top of the 12th row, but it depends on what looks best on your bear. On this one, I think it'll look better just above the 13th row. So I'm going to count down from the rings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. So the top of the muzzle is just above the 13th row. So just make sure that your muzzle is completely centered in between those ears, and that it looks good. And now you're going to pin it in place Use lots of pins. I'm putting the pins in on a slant because I'm going to be sewing around the pins and I don't want the yarn needle to be hitting the shaft of the pin. So go ahead and pin it in. Lots and lots of pins. The more pins, the better. Okay, there we go. You can see lots of pins. Now, more pins the better because the muzzle tends to move around as you're sewing. So the more pins you put in, the better chance is that muzzle is not going to be moving around anywhere. Okay, so I've threaded my yarn needle. Now I'm just going to go right into the head, right beside the muzzle, as close as to the muzzle as I can get it. I'm going to bring the yarn needle down and up through a stitch hole away from that muzzle. Okay, going to go back in the same stitch hole I just came out of. And I'm going to go and put a stitch in the top. So I'm coming up just above the top of the muzzle, as close to the muzzle as I can get it. Okay, I'm going to go back in. I'm just going to catch the top of that muzzle. And I'm going to come out onto the side. Now I'm going to do these two sides. Going back in the same stitch hole I just came out of. Going to go down and come up just beside this muzzle as close as I can get it. Now catching this stitch right here, went back into the head, down and away. That side, and that side stitch down. Now I'm just going to do this one. Going back in the same stitch hole I was just in, coming up beside the muzzle. And then going right beside the muzzle and down into the head and away. You can see what I did there. I stitched the bottom, the top, and the two sides. Now I'm going to go in back through the same stitch hole I just came out of, and I'm just going to go around the muzzle. Always coming up as close as I can to the muzzle. Go back in and come up where it's comfortable. You don't have to come right beside where you just came in. You can go back and forth, it doesn't matter. In. Okay, I think some of these pins can come out of here. I'm gonna check how that muzzle looks. I could put pins back in if I need them. Okay, now that it's been mostly sewn in, I can take some stuffing if I need it. Take a little bit at a time, and I can see a gap right here, so I'm just going to put it right close to that gap, and I'll use my stuffing stick, and I'll push that stuffing into the muzzle. A back end of a pencil works great too, if you don't have a stuffing stick. Now I can use a stick, move that stuffing around as much as I need to. Okay, I think that's good. So now I'll just finish closing up these gaps. Okay, I think that looks pretty good. So there, all the gaps have been sewn closed. I'm just going to take this yarn. I'm going to wrap around a stitch post right there. Any stitch will do. Pull through that loop and pull tight. That just knotted it off. Now I'm going to take this yarn tail and just carry it away into the face, pull on it slightly, and cut. Here's a quick tutorial that will show you how to add button eyes to your doll and also how to glue on safety eyes. And I'm going to show you two different methods. One is how to glue the eyes in, the safety eyes in, and one is how to add buttons. Now this is just a regular button. This will work for a solid button that has a hole in the back as well. If you have solid buttons, those will work. This one's already been put in, and you can see there's no yarn tails to be seen on the back, and it's securely on there. It's not going anywhere. I'll show you that in a minute. Now, all my other videos, I've always used fabric tack or tacky glue, and that works well. The only problem is it can get onto your doll if you don't do it exactly how I show you. Now, I found this new stuff here, and it's called Fabric Fusion, and it's in a pen. I mean, how cool is that? And you can get it right on the stem of the safety eye and you don't have to worry about it going all over the place. Now this stuff works really well. I just watched a video on YouTube and the lady was using Fabric Fusion to add glass, metal, plastic, beads to her fabric, and apparently this stuff holds it on, and you can even wash the thing after it's dried. Okay, so this one has been glued in already, and I'm going to show you how to do this one here. So what you want to do is you want to make sure that you're getting it on the stem. I get it all around the stem and all around the base of the stem. Now you don't want to put gobs and gobs and gobs because it will ooze out the sides, and you don't want to get this on your doll. Okay, and now we're just going to push it in there. And you can see some of that glue is going to be shoved right up to the behind the eye, and that's good. And I'm just going to push it in, and it's done. Now you're supposed to leave this for 2 to 4 hours. Let it dry for 2 to 4 hours before you start pulling on it. And if there's any glue on the outside of the eye, make sure you get that off. So I want to thread my yarn through the button, but my yarn needle won't fit through the buttonhole because it's just too small for the eye of the yarn needle. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a regular sewing needle, and I've just made a little loop of thread. So I'm going to pull my yarn through that loop. And I've decided which side is going to be the front of my button. So I want to start through the back side. I'm going to crisscross through all these holes. So I'm going to come up through the back side, pull my yarn through, and then I'm going to go over one buttonhole and go back in. And I'm going to come through the back side again and back over on the remaining buttonhole. And there, I've just crisscrossed all those buttonholes. So I can take this thread loop off. And now I'm going to thread my yarn needle. So I'm just going to bend over the yarn and push the bend through. Okay, and I already know that I want the button to go right about there. So I'm going to go through a stitch hole and bring the yarn needle through the back, through a stitch hole. Make sure you're coming through stitch holes. Go and thread the other one now. Now I'm going to go in, but I'm not going to go through the same hole that I have the other one going. I'm going to go one post over. And when I go out, I'm going to go through the same stitch hole that that other yarn tail is coming through. So in through a different stitch hole and out through the same stitch hole. Okay, so now I could knot these off, but what I want to do is I want to add a little drop of glue back there. So I'm going to use my fabric fusion. Now I could pull those yarn tails tight. So now we want to knot these yarn tails off in the back. I'm going to do 2 knots, and I'm pulling a little tight because it makes a little bit of an indent here. It's kind of cute. And now I'm going to thread both these yarn tails again. And I want to get rid of this knot back here. So I'm going to go back in the same hole that these thread tails are coming out of. And I'm going to go down and come out somewhere else. Now I'm going to pull on these thread tails. I'm going to pull quite hard so I can bring up the thread tails as far as they'll come. And then I'll snip. And now when they spring back in, they're gone. And they're completely hidden away. So that's the end of this tutorial. Hope you had fun, and I hope you get yourself a little bunny made. And remember, if you made yourself a little bunny, please post pictures on my Facebook page, Amgrooming Freely. I'd love to see. Thanks so much for watching.